भगवान की, प्रहलाद महाराज की, किलो प्रभुपाद की, हिताय गौर प्रमानंद।
कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम, राम राम हरे हरे। वेलकम ऑल टू दिस कॉन्फ्रेंस फिलाडेल्फिया फॉर द संडे फिश प्रोग्राम। आई सी मेनी न्यू फेसेस टुडे आई गेस। इज देयर एनीवन हु इज विजिटिंग अस फॉर द टाइम फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम? इफ यू आर हियर प्लीज रेज योर हैंड। व्हाट्स योर नेम? शीना। Where are you from? Philadelphia. What's your name?
Vimani.
Vimani from where?
Vancouver.
Vancouver. Anyone else? Yes, what's your name?
My name is Brian.
Brian.
Yeah.
And you're where are you from?
From Upper Darby.
Upper Darby. Okay. Anyone else? Okay, let's welcome them to our temple. Thank you for coming. Is very special day. Today is the first day of the Kartik month, the holy month, and we are celebrating Sharad Purnima festival. And as you know, like our name is Shri Radha Sharad Bihari ji. So it's a very special day, and our schedule is we are going to have a discourse, a class. This will go until 5:30, and 5:30 we are going to break for dinner, prasadam, that will be served in the dinner hall of the building, and at 6:30 we are going to come back for a mantra meditation session or the japa meditation, and at 6:45 for another. So please stay for the full program here. And today's class will be given by His Grace Gokulananda Prabhu. I request all of you to
Tadamadava Sunya Bihari.
Om Vishnu Pad Pramukh Parivacharya Astotara Sat सरस्वती गोस्वामी महाराज प्रभुपाद ठाकुर समवेता भक्तवृंद प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य श्री नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवास भक्तवृंद जय प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि ओम गुरु कृष्ण बोलि हो। वेल वी विल बी चैंटिंग दिस वर्स फ्रॉम भगवद गीता चैप्टर 2 वर्स 21। वेदा विनाशिनम नित्यम
विनाशिनं नित्यं
ध्यायेनं वदाव्ययम् कथं सपुरुषा पार्थ कं कात्यति हन्तिकम्
वेदा विनाशिनं नित्यं
एनम अजम
अव्ययम् कथं सा पुरुषा पार्थ कं घात्यति हन्तिकम्। वेदा विनाशिनं नित्यं
येनम अजम अन्यम्
कथं स पुरुष पार्थ कं घातयति हन्तिकम्। वेदा विनाशिनं नित्यं येनम अजम अव्ययम्
कथम सा पुरुषा पार्थ कम घात्यति हान्तिकम्।
So what the word translation meanings is Veda, who knows. Avinash.
Who?
Enam. This.
Ajam.
Anmo.
Avyayam.
Immutable. Katam.
Katam.
How?
How?
Sa.
Sa.
That. Purusha.
Purusha.
Person.
Person.
Parth.
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 Come,
come,
home.
Gatayati.
Gatayati.
Causes to be killed.
Causes to be killed.
Hanti.
Hanti.
Kills.
Kills.
Come.
Come.
Home. Translation, commentary, and purport by Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada. O Bhagavan, how can one who knows the soul to be imperishable, eternal, unborn, and immutable, kill anyone or cause anyone to kill? The commentary given by Srila Prabhupada is, a spiritually elevated soul quells the ego that makes us feel that we are the doers of our own actions. And in that state, one can see that the soul seated within actually does nothing. Such an elevated soul, to doing all kinds of action, is never tainted by him. Sri Krishna is advising Arjuna that he must elevate himself so that to enlighten the level, seeing himself as non-doer and free from the egotism, and perform his duty rather than shirk from it. Purpose. Everything has its proper utility, and the man who is situated to complete the knowledge knows how and where to apply a thing for its proper utility. Similarly, the violence also has its utility, and how to apply violence rests with the person in knowledge. Although the justice of the peace awards the capital punishment to a person condemned for murder, the justice of the peace cannot be blamed, because he orders violence to another person according to the course of justice. In Manu Samhita, the law book for mankind, it is supported that a murderer should be condemned to death, so that in his next life he will not have to suffer for the great sin he has committed. Well, therefore, the king's punishment of hanging a murderer is actually a beneficial. Similarly, when Krishna, he orders fighting, his instruction, it must be concluded that the violence is for the supreme justice, and thus Arjuna should follow the instruction, knowing well that such a violence committed in act of fighting for Krishna is not violence at all, because at any rate the man, or rather the soul, cannot be killed. And so for the administration of justice, so-called violence is permitted. A surgical operation is not meant to kill the patient, but to cure him. And therefore the fighting to be executed by Arjuna at the instruction of Krishna is with a full knowledge, So there is no possibility of sinful reaction. Hare Krishna. Om Agnanatimirandasya Jnananjana Salakaya Chakshuram Militam Ena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namah. Om Chaitanya Manobhistam Stapitam Ena Bhutale Svayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadanti Svapadantikam. हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीन बंधु जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधा वृंदावनेश्वरी विश्वानु सुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये वाचा कल्पतरुवश्च उपासिन्धु एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः. श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानन्द यद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृन्द. हरे कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे. So, we have been studying the first and foremost teachings of Bhagavad Gita, the Song of God. And this teaching is, the very first and foremost teaching of Gita is what? What is the first and foremost teaching of Gita?
I am not this body.
We are not the body. We are the soul. And the science of soul in this chapter, the contents of Gita summarized. This is the song of God, and that's what we're going to finish today. In a plain language, for the soul there is a neither birth nor death. Soul has not come into being, does not come into being, and will not come into being. The soul is unborn, eternal, ever-existing and primal. Soul is steady versus body is temporary. Difference between the consciousness of the soul and the supreme. The supreme soul knows the past, present and future. Supreme soul is Krishna. He knows the past, present and future. But the individual soul is prone to forgetfulness. We don't know what was our last birth. We don't know what's going to be next birth. We don't know what will be tomorrow, and we don't know what was it even here. Well, the relationship between Krishna and Arjuna. Krishna is a fountainhead of the super soul, and Arjuna is an atomic soul. He's a tiny soul, atomic soul just like us. Atomic soul forgetful of his real nature. Arjuna asks Krishna in a battlefield. What is Krishna asking in battlefield? Karpanya doso prahat svabhava pruchamitam dharma samudha chitta. Very nice. His mind is miserly weak. He's confused, he's bewildered, and therefore the Arjuna needs enlightenment by Krishna. He accepts that I am your disciple and I surrender to you for further instruction. So who can understand the glories of the soul? Only one who attempts to free from all material desire. This is what Krishna says. This is what the scriptures say. The one who attempts to be free from all material desires and lamentation, and by grace of Supreme Lord. So Prabhupada explains that Aja is important. Aja. Aja isam abhyaya atma. What is the difference between us and Krishna? We are also Aja, Prabhupada says. Aja means unborn. We are also unborn. We are a soul. We are conscious about our own body, but super soul is conscious about everyone or all living entity. We are present in our heart, but he is present in everyone's heart. That is Krishna. So we saw that the soul is eternal, is the individuality. Soul is transmigrating from one body to another. But then the question arises whether it can be destroyed or can it be killed. And Krishna says, no, it is avinashi, avyaya. Avinasi tat vritti. There is no decay. No decay in soul. Soul is as it is. So now the question arises, does the immortality of the soul recommend violence? I mean, if we told somebody, you know, what Gita is all about, and we suddenly say, well, it is a book where, you know, God teaches Arjuna how to kill everybody. Nobody would ever read Gita, would they? But there is a whole science, the science of soul behind it, which you don't find in any scriptures as I understand. So now the verse says, the question arises, whether does the mortality of the soul recommend violence? Sa says no. Supporting references in purport 219, Vedic injunction. Ma hinchaya sarva bhutani, never commit violence to anyone. Killing the body of anyone without the authority is abominable and punishable by law of the state as well as the law of Lord. If somebody escapes because of corruption, this law of material, you are still liable for the law of spiritual, law of the Lord. So material and spiritual laws, they are there to punish anyone without authority. However, criteria to use violence, forcefulness, or aggression under the guidance of observance of the proper authority, then there is no sinful reaction. I think that's what Krishna was really explained, or Prabhupada explained in a purport, that if he follows what Krishna is saying, then there is no sinful reaction. So that is what explained Prabhupada in the above purport. Who decides the proper utility? A man situated in complete knowledge, a Vedic knowledge, who knows how and where to apply a thing for its proper utility. So it's not only merely for killing or anything. I mean, we saw the example given, the analogy of justice. You know, justice has to fall and he punishes the criminals. Same way, the example of doctor was given. The doctor uses knife, the criminal uses knife. Criminal uses knife just for the violence or hurt or kill somebody, while doctor uses the same knife to cure us. So similarly, I think whatever was committed, I think the anger and violence, we can say even in spiritual, like Hanuman. Hanuman did a violence when he went to Lanka and he destroyed Ravana's property, he killed so many demons to justify release of Holy Mother Sita. An injustice done to Lord Rama. A victory of good over evil to establish godly qualities over demonic activities for justice. How to justify Arjuna's use of violence is not a question. He was Kshatriya, he was a superior warrior and had to protect good over evil. That was his dharma. He was killing for the principle of religion. He was killing for the principle of religion. So everyone's karma, they will have to be punished, and yet no harm was done, as souls cannot be killed and new bodies will be given. Person in knowledge in Vedas knows how and where to apply so-called violence or motivating technique. There are some motivating technique where it might use violence, you might use some sight of force. Criminal use of light to kill people, in case of doctor we just saw, that's to cure people, that's not a violence. So from Canto 4, there is an example. The good example was given of King Vena. I mean, King Govana was a very cruel and antagonistic. He was a notorious king. Even criminals were afraid of him because he was a negative-minded. He was a negative-minded and was against the spiritual premium. Now there are so many Brahmins, so many sages and rishis living in the kingdom. And they see the Brahmins, the great sages who were responsible for the spiritual cultivation in this kingdom and had him killed to save innocents. It was the sages and Brahmanas who were responsible to kill King Vena. And that was justified violence because he was a notorious king. So Brahmanas or sages cannot help but assist and advise the king to help him. But finally Brahmana found a right person from Vena's leading boy. And that happened to be Prithu Maharaj. Prithu Maharaj reached, who is empowered incarnation of Lord Vishnu. Due to the mischievous activities of King Vena, the religious principles were almost lost. And upon opportunity This Prithvi Maharaj descended as the incarnation of Lord Vishnu. So this dharmo rakshati rakshitaha. You know, you protect the religion, similarly one must protect dharma. Demand justice for dharma and dharma will protect us. Activity done on order of authority or guidance of spiritual leader is not sinful. Here's a good example. I mean, it wasn't the violence, but Prabhupada, like when we wanted Rath Yatra, the first Rath Yatra in New York, I believe, was 1968. And Prabhupada wanted this Rath Yatra in New York City on Fifth Avenue, the busiest avenue. Well, he knew it is a difficult proposal, but he wanted Lord Jagannath to bless New Yorkers and propagate this Krishna moment, a Mahamantra. And it was a great success that he got the permission for Rath Yatra. You know why? Because there was law in New York since 1962. The mayor had a law. They had a prohibition that they cannot have parade on Fifth Avenue or any avenue in New York because of the traffic management and so many problems. So how to get around it? To get Lord Krishna on the streets of New York, which we still enjoy today? Well, Prabhupada, when he heard, he was amazed at how they got permit. I understand from Nilamrita and others that Toshan Krishna Prabhu, who had managed, and he was asked how he succeeded to get this permit. He told on application that he simply mentioned in application that we are going to drive three hand-pulled carts on the road with deities. That's all we are going to do. And we will be serving prasadam. And he got the seal of approval. Until today, they couldn't take it back. We have Rath Yatra every year. We are enjoying this Prabhupada's motivation because Toshan Krishna Prabhu said it was a mercy. It was a mercy of Prabhupada. It was mercy of Krishna. And this is how they approached the mayor. So this incident, he intelligently expressed when they told Prabhupada that, yes, we got permit like that. So Prabhupada says, oh, we are in line with Vamandev Prabhu. Vaman had asked only three steps from Raja Bali. Here we had just asked for three pulled cards, and here we succeeded. So we are enjoying Niragatha even today due to Prabhupada's mercy. Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
This is another incident I like to share very quickly, and that was today Russia is considered the second most popular after US in propagating the Mahamantra. And Prabhupada's message is all across Russia. And interestingly, how they passed through, there is an interesting story. This movement got succeeded in Russia during earlier years of communist government, where practicing religious movements, book distributions were prohibited. In communist country, I don't know, some like Bulgaria, you cannot go to church if you are under 55. People only above 55 can go to the church. This was part of Eastern European countries where same thing prevailed because the whole idea was religion gives you all freedom, all confidence, all everything that you need to get, gain the confidence to fight your own problems or the country's problems. So going back to this Russia, it was Sarva Bhavanadas. He wrote a very good book called Salted Bread. Salted Bread, which is about the persecution of the Russian and Armenian devotee in the early days of USSR. The book is on account of painful experiences of the first attempt to spread Krishna consciousness in a atheistic country, which was Srila Prabhupada's desire. Prabhupada wanted Krishna's movement to go in Russia. This guy is fought and fought. The stories of devotees, there were trials in jails. They were sent to psychiatric hospitals. There was encounters by KGB. KGB is like equivalent to our CIA, but a very notorious spying agency. So the KGB or our FBI and others, but the author does not lack in humor. He recalls it, that all this pain, but it was a blissful past. Prabhupada and Krishna was in front of us all the time. In the modern day, devotees of Krishna or Prabhupada can be as tolerant as was Prahlad Maharaj. In the middle of sheer nastiness and cruelty, these people did not stop. This is an important history of the beginning of Krishna conscious movement in Eastern European countries. This, in modern days, people have paid this kind of price. Not only that, he said his best devotee, the one who assisted him, I think his name was Sachisuddha Prabhu, he had left his body in the prison because he was chanting Hare Krishna mantra. He was beaten up in jail, but he never gave up till he died. This is the type of price even they pay. You cannot take Gita book in Krishna, printed book in those days in communist government. Somehow they sneaked in few books, and then they were handwritten Gitas they started, because if they published they would be caught by KGB. So they had handwritten Gita that they were distributing. So this is the kind of price people have paid in name of Guru and Gauranga. One would have to have a heart of stone not to be permanently affected by this kind of stories. Well, the bowl is called salted bread. I have an Armenian friend. I was asking him why he named the salted bread. He says when some guest comes in important, we greet them with salt, water and bread. Bread signifies food, salt signifies, you know, putting some essence in there, and water gives you the energy. So he said, we always greet the nice people with salt, water and bread. This is the tradition. So since he succeeded in his Russian movement, the book he named was The Salted Bread. Well, today the Russian Ukrainians are the second most popular after USA in spreading Prabhupada's message, movement and Mahamantra. Well, Prabhupada says the Vedic literature, we find that both the Lord and the living entity, they are situated in the heart. The living entity, Jiva, is desiring, Master is sanctioning, and the Prakriti, or the material nature, is giving the body. Therefore, the original cause of our engagement of liberation is our desire. As we are desiring, if you want, if you desire to become free from the implications of birth, death, old age, and disease, it is ready, and if you want to continue this implication, change of body, because you cannot enjoy the spiritual life in this material body. You can enjoy this material world with material body. And if you want to enjoy the spiritual life, then you have to enjoy the spiritual body. But as we have no information of the spiritual life, spiritual enjoyment, we are simply desiring to enjoy this world with the material life. This is what Prabhupada says. If you diligently study and try to understand, you remain in fully Krishna consciousness always. Everything is there. What is my position? How am I working? How am I dying? How am I getting this body? How am I wandering? Everything is there. Well, I think today is auspicious day, it's Sarat Purnima day. We are talking about the soul, and we'll be meeting the super soul. This is time to say. It's like one of the best Gujarati poets, if you might have heard the name, Narsingh Mehta. He said one sentence, I'm concluding this chapter with his one sentence, if I have your permission. And then, Jaan lagi atma tat. Chintyo nahi tyan lagi sadhana sarva jhuthi. What he is saying is until we learn about the soul, learn about the Atma Tattva, learn about the soul's intents, then, till then, unless we learn it, our sadhana is all jhuthi, all lies. If you want to progress in sadhana, you must learn the soul, the science of the soul. And that's the message I think we have been carrying on chapter 2. And this is amazing. Kaviraj Krishnadas in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Adi 4, 15 and 16. Even Mahaprabhu came for all this reason, and he said, Premarasa niryasa karite asvadana raga marga bhakti loke करिते प्रचार रसिक शेखरा कृष्ण परम करुणा यही दोई हेतु हेते उच्चार उद्गम The Lord desire to appear was born from two reasons. Chaitanya Charitamrita Kaviraj Das says, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's appearance. The Lord's desire to appear was born from two reasons. The Lord wanted to taste the sweet essence of mellows of love of God. And he wanted to propagate the devotional service in the world on the platform of spontaneous attraction. Thus he knows as supremely jubilant and as the most merciful of all. This is Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, these acharyas and these Goswamis and the great sages all glorified the auspicious month. So which auspicious month is starting today? Which is the month? Kartika. And what is the auspicious day today other than Kartika?
Sarat
Purnima. Sarat Purnima day. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared to propagate all this. Today is the first day of Kartika. Truly the most glorious month as the first day is Sarat Purnima. And which was the famous Leela that was performed by Krishna today. What was that famous Leela that was performed today? Ras Leela. So, Sukadeva Goswami, Sukadeva Goswami describes to Maharaj Parikshit that on this most sacred and holy evening on the full moonlight of the month of Kartik, Sarat Purnima, in the forest of Vrindavan, the moon is rising on the eastern horizon. It's a beautiful golden color and all around the whole atmosphere is surcharged. Today is a Punam. Punam is a full moon day. Yeah, so, today is a Punam is considered the most beautiful and holiest among all as Krishna's Ras Leela was performed this day. So Sarat Purnima is when the Ras Leela was performed, when it was glorified by all demigods, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the Rishis, and this Ras Leela was performed on the banks of Yamuna River under the Kalpa tree at Bansibad. Krishna lifted Govardhan Hill when he was 7 years old. Just lifting on a little finger of a left hand, and the hill perimeter is about 21 to 22 kilometers. And this Govardhan Leela was performed by Krishna to take care of the demigod Indra's ego and protect the Vrajavasis from the rain god Indra's harassment. At the tender 7 years, he lifted Govardhan Hill. At the tender age of 8, one of the important Leela of Krishna that was glorified by Lord Chaitanya, the great sages, rishis, acharyas, goswamis, and so on. The sky seems as if it's painted with the beautiful, beautiful golden illuminating aura of the moon. The birds are singing with the sweet sounds, most pleasing to the ears. The wind is in its charming way and is blowing through the leaves, and the trees are singing a beautiful song. And indeed all night this is considered to be the king of beauty. The flowers like jasmine, the malti, the lotus, the chamele, and all were blossomed on this Sarat Purnima with the most inspiring fragrance. Krishna full in opulences. Yet upon seeing those autumn nights scented with blossoming jasmine flowers, he turned his mind toward loving affairs and romance. To fulfill his purpose, he employed his internal potency and yoga maya. But Prabhupada jokingly says many times, you know, that these materially oriented people, the mayavadis, sometimes they think about this romance and lust that was involved in the Krishna ras. Ask them, Prabhupada says, ask them to lift the Govardhan Hill. Then they can do the Ras Leela. They want the way Krishna did. The Yamuna was steady and still. It was quiet to welcome the Lord. The demigods, the Lord Shiva, the Brahma, Indra, Vishnu, gods and goddesses all arrived for the night to have a darshan of the Lord and his magnificent Ras Leela with gopis. This is the holiest Ras Leela. This is for the devotees to understand This is, the gopis were not an ordinary devotees. They were the highest and purest and surrendered devotees of the Lord. Gopiyastu tutugneva rusit gopa kanyaka deva kanyasit rajendra namanusya kathanchana. It is understood that some of the gopis are personified Vedic literature, while other were reborn sages and the daughters of cowherds and the demigods' maidens. But by no means, my dear king, are any ordinary, they were not ordinary humans. Here we are informed that although the gopis appeared to be human cowherd girls, they actually were not. Thus the contention that they are mortals is refuted. Also the gopkanyas, they were sadhana siddha perfect, bhakti yogi daughters of cowherd girls. And Nitya, the Siddhi Gopakanya, they were eternally perfect and the daughters of demigods. The whole forest of Vrindavan was intoxicated with the sweetness of his most auspicious evening. And thus with the heart of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Shyamasundara awoke the desire to enjoy the beautiful, stood in his three-folded bending form. His hair were decked with the peacock feathers, and he began to play his celebrated flute, the most charming fifth note, which captivates the hearts and minds of all living beings. The ambrosial sound of the celestial flute of Shyamasundara utterly polluted every molecule and every atmosphere of Vrindavan. And then when it enters into the ears of gopis, their hearts, minds and hearts became conquered by the sweet love. They went to their ears, into their hearts. And that was their most cherishable pleasure of life with their own heart. Whatever their occupation were, they could not even consider any importance. They simply ran to meet Krishna. They understood that Krishna is calling. And he is calling for us. Not a single gopi was thinking that let us enjoy with Krishna, but their feeling was, let us give pleasure to Krishna. Our heart, our soul and our life is simply to give the pleasure to Krishna. Our only desire and our only ambition is to give pleasure. Give pleasure to Krishna. Our heart, our soul and our life is simply to give pleasure of Krishna. It's a loving exchange with us and the Lord. Our only desire, our only ambition is to give pleasure to Krishna in this Rasa Lila, the dance with his most beloved gopis. And we have Vrindavan right here in Philadelphia. We are chanting and dancing with the Lord in the presence of Prabhupada and senior Vaishnavas. And that's exactly what Vrindavan was. Gopis were milking the cow. Some had half finished milking the cow. And when they heard the flute Sri Krishna, they could not even consider taking the time to even take the buckets away from the cows. They just ran to the forest. The milks were boiling. They left the milk boiling. They were feeding the families. Some were feeding their children, some were nursing the babies, breastfeeding the baby. They left the babies lying there. As we said earlier, remember in mind, these are not the ordinary gopis. She did not consider who will take care of my baby. She only considered Krishna is calling, and some gopis were about to take rest with their husband. But Krishna's flute entered their lives, and simply they left their husbands behind. It is the desire that some of the gopis, their protectors, some gopis were even so mindful, so fixed with the intense feeling of separation from Krishna, that some of the families even locked them in the door. They didn't let them go. And from the bottom of their heart, some of them left their bodies. Some of them were just intensely with Krishna. Some of them were putting up their cosmetics. Some of them were half done with cosmetic. They all ran and ran and ran. So gopis went deeper and deeper into the jungles, and they ran until they came upon this Bansiwar tree. There was a beautiful form of Govinda charmingly glancing upon them with his lotus eyes, and he began to speak. My dear gopis, it is a very nice of you to have come to meet me here in the middle of night, but it's very dangerous. You are all young girls. You have no power to protect yourself. There are lions, the tigers, and the moles and jackals all around. They are hungry to find the prey. You should go home immediately where it is safe and protected. Besides, you do not understand that you are a chaste woman, a pure woman, and you have husbands and protectors. Not only it is unsafe and they wanted to see was just enjoy and be with Krishna, because they waited for years and years, billions of years, to have the Krishna's touch, Krishna's love, the exchange of love. So when they heard that Krishna wants them to go home, the gopis said, they cried, Krishna, your words are like arrows in our hearts. You say that we should be attached to our family members. Why should we be attached? The fact is, my dear Krishna, your presence in our heart gives them a life. You are a Paramatma. You are the Super Soul. As soon as you leave anyone's heart, that person becomes dead corpse. Who is in love with the dead corpse? So Krishna, you are the only object and love are all times. Well, so they said, when you water the root of a tree, every part of the tree is nourished. All of our family members and everyone are part and parcels of you. If we satisfy you, then Krishna is bound that they will be satisfied. Gopis deeply and sincerely wanted to please him and serve him. But Krishna, he said, he is controlled by love of his devotees. When Mother Yashoda wanted to bind him, experience Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who was Krishna himself, he explained that there is no devotion superior to devotion of themselves of Vrindavan. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was a sannyasi. His sampradaya, all sannyasis must meditate on renunciation of the gopis, ultimate ecstasy, and enjoy the life. Because gopis are more superior persons. The gopis were even willing to sacrifice the pride and prestige of being pure and decent women for the pleasure of Krishna. Krishna cannot tolerate this pride in gopis' heart. When pride enters in your heart, Krishna leaves. So Krishna disappeared from the sight of the gopis. Krishna left to teach a lesson to gopis. Gopis were crying. Where is Krishna? He is from your dynasty. Krishna was Chandravansi. As you know, Rama was Suryavansi. Krishna was Chandravansi. They started asking moon and the stars, where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? They started pretending all these leelas like Kalyas and Putnas. They tried running mad, and running toward the Vrindavan jungles to make it short. They saw the footprints, and they had been guessing maybe he ran away with other gopis. When they saw the other footprints with it, surprisingly they saw divine gopi Radharani sitting in the corner under the tree, crying in the separation of the Lord for the life, the Lord of life, Krishna. Maharaj Parikshit asked Sukadeva Goswami, why, if they did not even know that he was a god, and they just thought he was a boy, 8 years is a boy, why such an exalted position? That means if any girl thinks of other boy with such an intensity, that they will become purified? Sukadeva Goswami said, the difference is that Krishna is a god. Krishna is a supreme absolute truth. Krishna is the proprietor of 6 opulences. Can you name any of those 6 opulences? What are the Krishna's 6 opulences? Wealth, renunciation,
beauty,
knowledge, strength, beauty, all fame and renunciation. Krishna is all attractive. That's what Krishna means, all attractive. Manmana madhavakto madhyanjivanamaskuru mame vaishyati satyamte pratidani priyosime. And therefore Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, always think of me, become my devotee, worship me and offer my homage unto me. In this way you will come to me without fail. And this is Krishna consciousness. In fact, in the very center, middle of the Gita, I think Bhagavad Gita, chapter 10, sloka 8, Aham sarvasya prabhavo mata sarva pravartate iti mam bhajante mam iti matva bhajante mam buddha bhava samanvita. I am the source of all spiritual and material worlds. Everything emits from me. The wise who perfectly knows this engagement in my devotional service and worship me with all their hearts. So where is our beloved Krishna? Everybody is hunting. Then Srimati Radharani came. I'm trying to sort of cut it short because the time constraint, but then the Lord Narayan appears in the forefront. In the presence of pure bhakti, Srimati Radharani, Krishna, although as hard as he could be trying to maintain, the Srimati Radharani recognized him and said, "You are Krishna," because he had come in the four arms posture. Then Krishna revealed the result of all gopis, and they began to enjoy the beautiful forest of Vrindavana. In other words, all that pride was taken from the heart, because Krishna really wanted to teach them a lesson. They danced and danced. There were thousands of gopis, and Krishna expanded himself. He was standing between each gopi. Each gopi, as they were dancing, were thinking that Krishna is looking only at me. Krishna is smiling. Krishna is smiling only at me. Krishna is dancing only with me. And Krishna is enjoying with my service. And the service I am offering, how merciful and how causelessly merciful he is. That Raslila still goes on. It lasted for one Brahma's night. One Brahma's night is millions of years. It's like four yugas, but thousand yugas. So the service I am offering, how merciful and how causelessly merciful. He, in this way, Lord Krishna completely satisfied all the gopis to offer this loving devotional service to him with the spiritual body. So beautiful night of Rash Purnima, we can meditate on the beauty and the glories of surrender. Some people think that surrender means to give up everything what we have. But the fact is, when we surrender everything for Krishna, you gain the supreme benediction of the eternal joy of the soul, the joy of love. Of course, after enjoying Rasalila, gopis wanted the Rasalila to go on and on. They never wanted it to end. Krishna, by his mystic power, allowed the Rasalila to go on for the entire night of Brahma, which is several million years. But he stopped the rest of time. So after those millions of years, it was sort of a 12 hours night. Because he turned the time back on, and it was just next morning for everyone. All gopis went home, and it is said that all gopis had no problem when they surrendered to Krishna. They are never the losers. The Rasalila is showing us the process of pure devotional service. We cannot imitate gopis of Vrindavana, but one thing we can do, we can humbly serve our Guru Maharaj, our Gurudev Prabhupada. And in this way we can follow in their footsteps. Well, I think the Rasalila can go on and on. The Rasalila goes on for years and years. Just to show the pure pristine quality of his most intimate reciprocation and pure spiritual emotion. Hare Krishna. Now is the Kartika. The first day of Kartika. Here comes the most auspicious month of Kartika. We welcome the most auspicious month, the festival of lamps and light, And that's what we'll be starting tonight. Remembering and glorifying the past time, we can attain the eternal abode. Rasa Lila, Govardhan Lila, Damodar Lila. Celebrate Diwali, the Vikramaditya ordained, and begin the Vedic calendar. The Surbhi Sao, Krishna's release of 16,100 princesses from Narakasura. Return of Lord Ramachandra, incarnation of Krishna. Appearance of Lakshmi Devi. Appearance of Dhanvantri, Ayurvedic science, and so on. So all the yogis try to capture him as Paramatma by meditation. Desiring to enter into the effulgence of the Lord, of the great austerities and penances. They fail to reach him. Even the yogis fail to reach Paramatma. But Mother Yasoda, thinking that same personality of God and Krishna to be her own son, began following Krishna. She began to catch him. Drashtva Parisham Krishna, Lord was tied up by devotion and devotional service. God was bound by the transcendental love. Prem ki rasi mein damodar band gaye. Damodar Lila is a very popular Lila that we celebrate in ISKCON. So from tonight onwards, we'll be doing Damodar Ashtakam. This month, the devotees make extra efforts and vows and perform the special spiritual activities and worship Damodar as explained earlier. Chaitanya Charitamrita explains in Adi Lila 4:22. Mora putra, mora sakha, mora prana pati, ehi bhave, e more kare sudh bhakti. Mata more, putra bhave, kare na bandhan, adehi. If one cherishes pure loving devotion to me, thinking of me as his son, his friend, his beloved, regarding him as a great, and consider me equal or inferior, I become subordinate to him. Mother sometimes binds me as her son. She nourishes and protects me, thinking me utterly helpless. Rupa Goswami says, Sudha Bhakti. In Nectar of Devotion, he has explained this whole thing. And the Lord Chaitanya, that is foremost important to connect and relate with Krishna. The transcendental love and knowledge help us, keep us in Krishna consciousness at all times, and attain devotional service to Lord Krishna. I think I tried to cover so many things in just 45, 50 minutes. So I'm sort of trying to run out of time. But like Satyavrata Muni says, when we do the Damodar Ashtakam, Varam Deva Moksham, the Moksham Vadimva. O Lord, I don't want liberation or eternal life in Vaikuntha. I want Bal Gopal form even manifest in my heart to realize and cherish your pastime forever. And same by end with my Gujarati poet and a dear God, Narasimha Mehta. He says, Bhutar Bhakti Padarathamurtum Brahmalokama Nahire. Bhutar Bhakti Padarathamurtum. He's asking, Lord, that I want to serve you. I don't want the moksha. I'm not looking for liberation. I want your seva for years. Lord appeared 5,000 years ago in Vrindavan. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared almost 500 years ago in Navadvip, Puri and Vrindavan. And His Grace Srila Prabhupada appeared almost 50 years ago in the West and touring the world 12 times to personally deliver Mahamantra to all of us. Make us all Krishna consciousness. Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare.
I'm sorry, I'm running over the time probably, but if you do have a comment and question.
So, Prabhuji, you have delivered wonderful, impactful sermon.
Thank you.
Very, very good job. Almost like a gopi when you were talking.
So we are all gopis, that was Krishna saying, so that's...
Yeah, so my question is that, you know, this gopis out, is it a gradual process of the bhakti yoga, or it can be spontaneous as well, especially for the, you know, the soul of this time?
Very good. The Gopi Bhava very well explained in Nectar of Devotion in a one way that initially, you know, there is sadhana bhakti, then there is what they call spontaneous devotion. You know, once you start this disciplinary principle, you start following Krishna, in the terms of ISKCON I am trying to explain you. Once you start to follow this procedure, then that's not the end of it. That leads you to the sadhana bhakti. But then there is another bhakti which is called spontaneous devotion. That's what gopis have. I mean, the minute they hear the sound, the fifth note from the flute, they just ran. And they were not ordinary. They were sages who were waiting to have darshan of Krishna in this form. They waited for million years. That's how it is described. So here it is. We can have same gopi bhava, but you have to come to the stage of spontaneous devotion. I think I am also a fallen servant just like you and I. I mean, we are trying all to achieve that kind of bhava with sadhana bhakti. We are trying to uplift ourselves and become real gopis. In fact, although I am running out of town, you know the Mirabai, when she went to Vrindavan to see Sanatan Goswami, and Swami was inside doing his seva and all that. And so she is asking, you know, that I want to meet Swami, the Sanatan Goswami, his darshan. And Sanatan Goswami said, I don't meet women, you know, a female by themselves. So that time Mira heard that, and then she replied that I heard there is only one Purusha in this world. Everybody else was a gopi. So Hare Krishna, I hope.
Thank you, Gopal and Ananda Prabhu, for starting us off in this holy month of Kartik. Tonight we will be celebrating the Sharad Purnima festival, which is the night in which this Rasa Leela takes. And it's also the first night in which we offer lamps to the lordships. So this is a time of the year that a lot of devotees we look forward to. It's a special time where we celebrate and read about and observe the youthful pastimes of Lord Krishna. It's also a time every night we will have an offering of lamps to Krishna. So we invite everybody to come, not just tonight, but every night at 7 o'clock. You can come, we'll sing the Damodarastika prayers, and you can come and offer a lamp to glorify the Lord. Tonight we will have special aarti starting at 6:45, where we'll be able to offer these lamps for the first night of this holy month. I'd like to, we have two anonymous fee sponsors tonight. I'd like us to, they ask that they not be revealed, but they do ask for the blessings of the devotees and their lordships. So let us raise our hands and chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra on their behalf.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So on Wednesday night, we have our Wednesday night kirtan. We invite everybody to come out and join us starting at 6:30. So even if you're not, you know, you're not able to come, maybe you can try to make it during this month of Kartik. This is a month, I forgot to mention, where we usually take some type of vow. We do a little bit extra. You know, if it's something that we can do, if there's a little obstacle that we have, or something that we just want to do a little bit more, this is a good time of the year during this month to take a step forward to Krishna. So you have a couple of opportunities here at the temple you can do that. So on Wednesday night is our kirtan night. And then also Thursday is our Srila Prabhupada Leela night, where we can learn about the activities and pastimes of how His Divine Grace spread the Hare Krishna movement. And then throughout the month, we'll also have lots of festivals that go on. Diwali, Govardhan Puja, we'll observe Srila Prabhupada's disappearance day. There's the marriage of Tulsi and Shalagram. So we'll be celebrating these festivals throughout the month. So we're going to serve out prasadam now in the other room at 6:30. We'll reconvene to do our japa session from 6:30 to 6:45, and then we'll have our Dhammadharastakam and the first night of Lamb's offering at 6:45. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.